More news tonight. They say they are victims not only of tough economic times, but of the bank they did business with.
KMBC 9's Bev Chapman is live in the Northland with the story of one store's unusual closing sale. Bev?
Laura, Belle Maison would have celebrated its 6th anniversary. It's an interior decorating store. Would have celebrated were it not for the fact that it's now holding a liquidation sale because it found itself with a collapsed bank in the middle of an economic downturn.
We have a lot of money invested in this that we're going to lose.
In a space packed with all the joy of Christmas, these are unhappy times for the women who own Belle Maison.
It's sad because this is a one-of-a-kind in the Northland.
Over 5,000 square feet, all of it packed with home decorating items. Now all of it must go.
We had no idea that our bank wasn't viable. Normally, most people think, well, if you make your payments, if you're paying your bills, that you're okay. You don't think about the institution.
This summer, state and federal regulators took over Colombian Bank and Trust of Topeka, one of several seized to avoid collapse. The Belle Maison had a line of credit with the bank, money they used to buy inventory. Now they're being forced to liquidate to pay off the FDIC, even if they wanted to continue.
But getting another loan
is impossible.
They've cleaned out the second floor and are busy eliminating the rest. Time is running out. They expect they will have to pay back the loan before Christmas. There are bargains for people who are still shopping, but for the owners, this is the death of a dream.
Both of us had ideas of when we retired from the mortgage business, being able to work in our own store. Obviously, that is not going to happen.
Back live, yes, you heard her right. Both Rose and Maureen Fry are in the mortgage business. Rose works with FHA loans. They both know exactly what they're up against in this economy. Mm. Back to you.
Wow, Bev, did they own that building?
Rose owns the building, but she says you can drive up and down North Broadway and elsewhere here in the Northland and see a lot of space available signs, and now her building may be among them.
All right, thank you, Bev. Deposits from the Colombian Bank were transferred to Citizens Bank of Chillicothe. The FDIC is handling Colombian's debt portfolio.